Nervous tissue. Nervous tissue is a tissue that is present in brain, spinal cord, and it is distributed in all parts of the body. And the main function of this nervous tissue is to bring about coordination between different organs by sending signals from one organ to another organ. It is made up of cells called neurons. Apart from neurons, there are some glial cells also. Simply you can call glial cells or neuroglial cells. There are some ependymal cells in the nervous system. And there are some neuroregulatory cells. These are like any other cells. Those cells which are having secretory function. We have studied about these tissues in squamous epithelium, secretory function. What they secrete? Neurotransmitters. Okay. They are secretory cells. They form a part of epithelial cells. Ependymal cells are epithelial cells that cover the brain. Epithelial cells of brain and spinal cord. So they are also part of epithelial cells. Neuroglial cells are those cells of connective tissue which support neurons. So apart from the neurons, there are other cells associated with brain and spinal cord. But exclusively when you are studying nervous tissue, we study about neurons only. Because these are related to other types of cells. These are epithelial cells, this is connective tissue cells. So, we'll study about neurons only here. Sir, duster le diya. The paper stream pe na. Tisko stara. Structure of neuron. First we'll study the structure of neuron, afterwards we'll study the types of neurons. Structure of neuron is very simple structure. It has star shaped cell body from which projections will arise. And so this is the basic structure. In this neuron, this part from here to here, it is called as cell body. The other name for cell body is cyton. Other name for this is soma. So there are three names, cyton, cell body or soma. Means cytoplasm plus Nissl granules and the central nucleus. It includes nucleus. Till here, this portion is called as cyton. Okay, this is nucleus. What are Nissl granules? In the cytoplasm of nerves, neurons, there are small granules which are called as Nissl granules. They are similar to ribosomes and endoplasmic reticulum of other cells. Okay. Nissl granules are equal to, they are equal to ribosomes and endoplasmic reticulum of other cells. They are useful for protein synthesis. Which proteins? Here there are so many nerve fibers extending inside the nerves. These nerve fibers are made by this Nissl granules. Okay. From cyton, there are so many projections that are coming out. The shorter projections that come out of cell cyton are called as dendrites. The longer projection, longest projection that comes out of this cell body is called as axon. The region from where the axon arises is called as axon hillock. And ending of this axon has some lateral branches like this. These are called as nerve terminals. You can call them nerve terminals. You can call them axon terminals also, because it is ending in the axon. Axon is ending in this, that's why it's called as axon terminal. Nerve is also ending here, it is called as nerve terminal. End of this nerve terminal, there is a knob-like structure. This knob-like structure is called as synaptic knob. Synaptic knob is also called as, wait a minute, I'll say it. Terminal buttons. Synaptic knob or terminal buttons. This axon is covered by a sheath, fatty layer, which is called as myelinated sheath, or simply myelin sheath. This myelin sheath is not continuous, it leaves some gap in between. These gaps are called as nodes of Ranvier. This sheath is made up of cells. This is one cell, this is one cell, this is one cell, this is one cell. What I am drawing now is nucleus. This is nucleus of this cell. This is nucleus. So there are cells. We are seeing in two dimensionally, we are seeing less cells. But total surrounding is made up of cells only. What is the cells which is made? Schwann cells. Schwann cells are present. Okay. So that is the general structure of a neuron. Any part is missing? Okay, another name for this cell body is perikaryon. Around nucleus it is present, so it is called as perikaryon. So these are the parts of a neuron. Nucleus, perikaryon, cell body, cyton or soma means this nucleus and whatever is present around that, including the Nissl granules and cytoplasm. After that, the projections that come out of this cell body are dendrites, axon. Axon is the longest one, dendrites are the shortest one. The region where the axon arises is called as axon hillock. Axon is covered by myelin sheath. This myelin sheath is made up of Schwann cells. Myelin sheath leaves small gaps in between, and these gaps are called as nodes of Ranvier. End of the axon, there are branches called nerve terminals or axon terminals. And here the end of this nerve terminal has a small bulged portion called terminal buttons or synaptic knobs. So that is the structure of neuron. Now let us see the types of neuron. First, based on the presence of myelin sheath. based on the presence of myelin sheath, they are divided into myelinated neurons and non-myelinated neurons. Myelinated neurons have myelin sheath around the axon, over the axolemma. Axolemma means the plasma membrane of this axon is called as axolemma. Around this axolemma, there are Schwann cells which have lot of fatty layer, fatty tissue. This is a fatty tissue. So much amount of fat is present around this, and it forms myelin sheath. If that is present, then it forms myelinated neuron. If it is not present, it is non-myelinated neuron. Not only in structure, in functioning also, myelinated and non-myelinated are different. Myelinated neurons can conduct impulse faster. These fat layer which is present around this acts as a insulating material. So the around the wire, we can see there is some plastic material. That is nothing but some amount of insulating material which does not allow the current to electricity to escape. This whatever signal is sent by this neurons, it is also called as nerve impulse, or you can call it as electric impulse also. This impulse generated by neuron is 0.05 volts. So it is some amount of electricity. When it is passing through this axon, the fatty layer that is present on either side acts as an insulating material and helps in fast conducting of nerve impulses. Whereas non-myelinated axons do not have this myelin sheath, their conduction of nerve impulse is slow. That is about first classification. Second classification. Based on structure, apolar neuron unipolar neuron bipolar neuron multipolar neuron. First, apolar neuron. The nucleus is in the center, cell body is present around it, and the projections that arise from this are all uniform. There is no one long, one short. All are equal type of projections. There is nothing one long, one short. So all the projections are equal length. This type of neurons are not present in human beings, they are present in Hydra. Since all the projections are of equal length, it is called as apolar neuron. Unipolar neuron has one projection that is coming out of the cell body. From cell body, only one projection is coming out. In the previous diagram when I drew about the dendrites and axons, I have drawn so many dendrites like this, one axon. But in unipolar neuron, only one projection comes out of the cell body. It divides into dendrites and axon. How to understand which one among this is dendrite and which one is axon? The smallest projection is, these are smaller compared to, this is larger. Smaller projections are called as dendrites and larger projections are called as axon. Dendrites are smaller projections, axons are larger projections. Coming to bipolar neuron, when two projections come out of a cell body, this is the cell body, this is nucleus, this side one projection, this side one projection. This is one projection, this is one projection. So this type of cells where two projections arise from a cell body are called as bipolar neurons. And we have already drawn the diagram of multipolar neuron. The previous diagram which I drew was the multipolar neuron, and so many projections are arising from a nerve cell. Okay. This is based on the structure. Next, based on functions, we can divide the neurons into three types. First one is sensory neuron. Second one is motor neuron. And third one is interneuron. As the name itself suggests, these sensory neurons carry the signals from sense organs to central nervous system. Inside all the sense organs, there are receptor cells which receive the signal. From there, the signal is received. See, for example, eyes. Eyes have photoreceptors. They receive signals in the form of light signals. Ears have auditory receptors. They receive signal in the form of sound. Nose has olfactory receptor. They receive signal in the form of smell. Tongue, taste receptors. They receive signal in the form of taste. Skin, cutaneous receptors. They receive signal in various forms of feelings, touch, temperature, pressure, etc. Okay, so all these receptors are present in sense organs, and nerve impulse is carried from sense organs to central nervous system. What do you mean by central nervous system? Brain and spinal cord together is called as central nervous system. Okay. Simply, instead of saying brain or spinal cord, I said central nervous system. That means some of the signals are reaching from sense organs to brain. Some of them will reach from brain to sense organ to only spinal cord, depending upon the signal. Whereas motor neurons send the signals from central nervous system, that is brain or spinal cord, to organ that is affected. You can simply say effector organ. This effector organ is usually muscle or gland. Muscle or gland. Like if you get signals that are related to your, for example, you got the signal that is related to sight. Something is coming in front of you and you should move back. Someone is coming to slap you very hardly, you should move your head back. At that time, what you will do? Your muscles related to movement of this head will function. Okay? You are moving your leg back. What happens immediately? The muscles that are present in legs are reacting, depending upon when you are feeling hungry. At that time, glands that are present in digestive system will react. So, the reacting organs usually are muscles or gland. Okay. Next, coming to interneurons. Interneurons are those neurons, they are present in central nervous system. That is, they are present either in brain or spinal cord. And they connect sensory neurons two motor neurons. Motor neurons. That means, let us assume this is brain and this is spinal cord. Sensory neuron is bringing the signal. Here to here there is interneuron. It is again carried by motor neuron. So this side it is sensory neuron that carries signals from semi sense organ to brain, and after that interneuron is present inside the brain and signal is received back by motor neurons. It can happen with spinal cord also. It is going here, here there is interneuron, again it is coming back. So internally there is distribution of interneuron inside the brain and inside the spinal cord. So either interneuron is present in the brain or in the spinal cord. So when you take a signal, how it is transferring? Sense organ first. Sense organs to sensory neurons, from there to brain or spinal cord. In this brain or spinal cord, the interneurons are present. From there, the signal is carried to motor neurons. From motor neuron, signal is carried to muscles or glands. Muscles or glands. Okay, so that is about the types of neurons based on function. So if you classify neurons based on myelin sheath, they are classified into myelinated neurons and non-myelinated neurons. If you classify based on structure, they are classified into apolar neurons, not present in human beings, unipolar neuron, bipolar neuron, multipolar neuron. Next, based on function, if you are classifying, they are classified into sensory neurons, motor neurons, interneurons. Interneurons are also called as relay neurons, or they are also called as association neurons. Sensory neurons are also called as efferent neurons. Motor neurons are also called as efferent neurons. Efferent means ingoing, incoming. Efferent means outgoing. Okay, but here one thing I'd like to say you, all unipolar neurons are sensory neurons, all bipolar neurons are motor neurons, all multipolar neurons are interneurons. So this is very important thing, children. All unipolar neurons are sensory neurons. All bipolar neurons are motor neurons. All multipolar neurons are interneurons. Okay, so that is about the classification of neurons. few children. Animal tissue completed. Next, we have to study the morphological structures of frog, cockroach, etc.